watch the breakdown.
Let's do this.
First of all, I need to
like an anniversary, like I made it to a year.
Who cares?
Yeah, nobody really cares.
Anyways, we here?
Nope.
Tom, move.
That's Tom's line.
Season 3, episode 50, we here.
5/11.
Season 3, episode 50, we here every Thursday and Thursday. It's the breakdown.
It's almost the end of the year. That's your enthusiasm?
Alright, season 50, what do you want me to do? Fucking cartwheels?
Maybe it's season 3.
Oh.
Season 3, episode 50.
My name is KB.
I don't think it's
like
that.
Alright, yo, what's up?
You're doing this. That's the intro? Come on, KB. Let's do it for real.
Energy. I need some energy.
Come on, KB.
Are you fucking kidding me?
I'm serious.
I gotta be me.
You wanted the intro, so...
Season 3, episode 50!
Yeah!
We're here.
Chilling.
Every day on a Thursday. It's the breakdown.
Alright, Tony, you're up.
Season 3, episode 50. This is the breakdown. I am Tony, my voice. This is K Black. Let's camp out.
Time out.
We're not doing that. Every Thursday on the third.
We're just going to repeat? Like, I'm so confused right now. It's like take number 50.
This is going to be a waste of, like, time.
It's just more editing for me, really.
Whoa. So we're going to let KB do the intro?
Whoa. We don't use that kind of language here.
Sorry.
Ma'am. Huh. So where were we at?
I don't know.
I'm the camp out. How's it going? Shout out to KB for her birthday this coming Sunday, December 16th. You are a...
Sagittarius.
There you go, chillin'. If you guys are watching the show right now and it is 8 p.m. or 8:05 by the time that intro is done.
We're in the chat.
We're in the chat, super chatting live. If you guys want to donate, you're more than welcome to donate. If you don't want to donate, fine. Tone probably isn't in the chat just
because... I won't be there, ever.
He's...
Never there.
Jeffy.
So, yeah, I won't be there. It'll be KB and the camp out.
Yeah.
8 p.m. live chat.
Anyway. Let's get into this.
Giblets might be there, though.
Yeah. If you want to talk to a tone, more than welcome to get a giblet going. First up, we got 1214 is the restock. Oh, I don't know why it says restock. Oh, because they dropped in UK. Off-white Nike Zoomfly in the black colorway.
Trash.
Huh.
Horrible silhouette.
Huh.
Not comfortable.
Very comfortable.
They are very
comfortable.
Wild.
That's it's just true. a wild
comfortable.
They're comfortable.
Disgusting.
Next up, the highly anticipated release of the purple lobster Nike Dunk Low Concepts. All over the place.
I don't know about GS sizes, ladies. I think we're getting played.
Huh. Purple's fire.
Purple is super fire.
Super duper fire.
Good job, Concepts.
Good job.
Retail for 100, it's fire.
It's my favorite color.
Also, we got Nike Air Max, or actually it's a Dornbecker pack, is dropping. You got the 270 in the military color. You got the Zoomfly in this array of colors.
Dude, you should have airdropped me because you see what's going on.
You got the Nike Dunk Low in the Dornbecker colorway as well with the green and gold. You have the 97 and you have the Air Force One and also the, Jordan 15. First and foremost, shout out to all the kids that designed shoes. They all did a spectacular job in their own right.
Air Force One is fire.
These things dropping in grade school and men's sizes.
I do like the black and gold.
What black? Oh yeah, the 15.
I was never mad at the 15.
The pattern is nice on the upper.
I'm never mad
at it. It's like a quilted diamond pattern.
I like the 15.
You said you never did?
I was never mad at the 15.
Did you have
them? I did. I had like 3 pairs of them.
I like 16.
Figures you'd like those.
White in the Carolina.
16's are better.
Huh.
6 things.
It's a preference thing. Anyway, the 270s fire. I think they're all, you know, good in their own right.
5%?
The dunks are fire.
Yeah, probably not. next up, we got Nike Air Force One low noise canceling. If you guys saw last week or the week before was the high.
It's off-white. It's off-white or scratch up.
It doesn't look off-white.
Yeah, it does.
It doesn't. Trash. I mean, that's all they're really doing is just stealing that aesthetic.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. It's off-white design.
It still don't look like off-white.
Flip with the labeling. Like the extra material, the stitching, you don't see that?
No. Nike Air Foamposite 1 in this glitter aesthetic.
Trash.
Yeah, I'm not with it.
Garbage.
Nike PG 2.5.
Does anybody still wear foams?
Pendleton. Yes, people still wear foams.
Yes.
I'm not really big on this.
No.
No.
I don't like it. The color, nothing. Nike Air Max Dia SE.
What? I never
definitely
seen
Element 87
like
React up top a little bit.
A little bit of the Air Zoom Fly in there too, like a little bit. Looks like a little
What the fuck is going on at Nike? There's so many crazy shit out there.
Nike is innovating, I will say that.
Yeah, it's not for everybody. Not for sure, not for everybody.
Nike Air Jordan 1 High origin story, if you guys are familiar with the Spider-Man movie dropping this weekend.
They're a little cheap in person, but...
Yeah, the grade school pairs are a little cheap in person.
The grade school pair is always cheap.
Yeah.
I thought just the opposite. What? I think the grade school is stepping it up a little bit.
It did not look premium.
Not for this
pair. Well, I'll tell you how I when I see my pair.
What are you looking at me for?
Just see, let you know.
That's why we can't have nice things. Mercer Amsterdam Word 2.0 Night Mission. Kind of fire. I like this.
No. Absolutely not. The fuck is this?
What does it matter? It looks pretty dope. Like a, I like the silhouette.
Hospital shoe.
So the Apollo 17.
Yeah. I kind of like this.
Right, NASA. Cool. Like, buy what you like, not for the hype.
Exactly.
Nah.
Not big on this NASA shit going on, but I do like the aesthetic of the shoe.
Too much these days.
Silhouette's nice. The midsole, a little round. That might be the most obtrusive thing.
It looks like the tubular from Adidas.
Yeah. It's almost like a Balenciaga upper, if you look at it.
It's like a fashion high class.
I like this, though. Issue. I mean, what's the price point? The price point is
too much.
Down there.
What is it?
Moving on to 1215. You got Nike Air, Fear of God, two colors.
Oh, it's two colors.
Oh, there's a white one as well.
I already seen the black one.
Yeah.
Retail for $350. That's 3M on the toe box. That's nice.
3M on the toe box? What do you mean?
Right here, the little toe cap. Oh, shit. The toe cap right on top?
What do you mean?
That's 3M. Right here, look. I'm pointing at it right there.
That's 3M?
Yeah.
I thought it was rubber.
Nah.
Either way, this is probably, I have to see them in person because I really don't want to jump the gun.
In the middle, or is it just like
the
whole
in the back? You see that?
Oh, is it in the back?
Yeah, I don't know. So it looks premium. I'll give it that. I mean, I hope it's over $350.
The sole is cool, but I don't like wear that. It's too much. I don't like extra too much going on.
This shit is very high fashion.
Excuse you?
Like too much material, like going up with the ties around and all this shit.
Too much going on. Have you seen one of your bespokes?
That's an Air Max 1, though.
But regardless, that's a lot going on.
A lot going on.
I'm not saying it's
this
not
is
for
much
everybody.
More simple.
You're right, it's not for everybody.
I'm not talking shit.
I need to see them in person. I feel like after a certain length of foot, it's going to start looking weird.
It's not as premium as my bespoke, though. Definitely not.
I think the black one's going to be the pair that everybody's going to want.
Yeah.
The black one definitely looks better than the white pair.
Nike Kyrie 5 multicolor. Nike's LeBron
like
6.
Thing.
What top thing? The lace cover?
The foreskin.
You're like, Nike LeBron 16, I'm king. Retail for $185, black and gold.
Swear, it's your fault.
Moving on.
I'm not mad at this black and gold. You don't like that?
Yeah, it's nice. It's clean. All
right.
The black and gold is always nice.
Yeah,
or white and gold. I like white and gold better than black and gold.
On. All right.
Or gray and gold.
Gray and gold is nice. This is true.
Oh, hey.
Nike Air Max Plus, retail for $160. OG color. Blue,
fire.
Orange, fire.
Next. Can I read one? Or
I mean, it would be not. I stopped talking.
He took the whole fucking thing. Took the whole show.
It looks like he's actually
it.
Turning his back to you also.
Yeah, like
this
a little bit. I'm not going to
lie.
So you can see it better that way.
But
if I was looking at you like this, you wouldn't be able to see
it. How about pass it over so I could read one?
Yeah, but like, look. Go ahead, take it.
I don't want to read it now.
What? So why do you keep bitching about it?
Adidas Air Fear of God's shoot around?
Adidas?
What?
You said Adidas?
Nike Air Fear of God's shoot around. Yeah, that's exactly
what you're looking at. Okay, so 300. Those are trash.
Huh. I didn't even know that these are dropping, so.
Neither did I.
What the fuck?
Adidas Yeezy 350 Boost V2, send me Frozen Yellow.
Restock.
I mean, I like them.
You forgot to say restock.
Alright, 220.
No, you gotta say restock.
They obviously know it's not the first time they're coming out, fool.
I mean.
How many times did this drop?
This is the second time.
Second.
A lot of people are tight, they pay that resale price.
Thankfully, I didn't.
Yeah. I like them. They're nice in person.
Yeah, they are. They're very nice. Do you want to see them?
No, I've seen them plenty of times. I don't know if I'm going to get a pair, though. I'm like, if you
about it. NMD Women's two colors, 130. Maroon and like a mint and gray and like a raspberry pink.
The gray one's fine. That raspberry's dope. I'm not a fan of NMDs, though. That shit is...
NMDs are over. I don't even want to look at them.
What is this
maroon,
shit?
Maroon. Shout out to Maroon. Can't wait for my shoes.
There's a date on it? Was that a date?
Yeah, I was about to ask about the date.
A longitude? Who the fuck here? Moving along.
Air Jordan 3, Mocha, retail, $190.
I like those.
What?
And they're not dropping in grade school,
really
sizes
like
only.
I really like them.
I don't know why people are acting like they whack.
They're popping.
Of course they don't drop in grade school.
Yeah, that shit sucks.
The leather looks really nice.
A lot of people are heartbroken. No grade school pairs.
Oh. I don't understand you, Nike.
Air Jordan 12, winterized, retail for $225, all black upper.
They're actually good on feet.
Dookie!
These shoes are strapped.
I mean, I'm
like Gore-Tex.
Cookie.
Like a raincoat.
Oh, you're not.
Dookie.
Come on with it.
Dookie.
You want to do this one?
Oh, God.
Allie, Allie, May.
You don't like these?
No.
Fire. 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 Fire.
You don't like these?
Fire.
I don't like the fur. Like
you can take it off.
You can take it off.
It clips right off.
But I'm like... What
you're gonna get them regardless.
Allie, Allie, May.
They're saying you don't like them, but you're gonna have a photo shoot with them.
I don't like the fucking fur as well.
Can I?
But you can take off the fur.
Could you tell them what we're talking about, please?
You're not gonna put the photo right here?
Allie, Allie, May.
You just said it seven times.
Yeah, but you guys were talking, so I want to make it clear for the people watching the show.
These shoes is fire.
Fire.
Big fan. I'm disappointed they won't be in my size.
They're dropping. Where are they dropping?
My size.
They're dropping a kid?
What's that now? I don't know. Maybe.
Definitely not.
That's the way it looks. Like, it has a lot of potential.
That's
I'm not a fan of the wax laces.
I just don't like the fur. That's it.
And swap it out.
Take it right off.
And I'm not Save a fan it. Of this, like, contrast right here.
You like, you I like love this. It. I like I the pink it. And the purple.
I like
purple
that part. I like this part. This part right here bothers me.
I don't like the
black. I'm with the whole,
in my
I'm
size,
with all of it.
It might be fire, so we'll see.
So you're going to get
birthday
it.
Weekend.
Yeah. Somebody help her out for birthday.
Retail for 160. Send it to KB.
24 Kilates and Reebok Classic
Those
Nylon.
Fire.
Footballin'? Peck? I don't know. Alright. Green and red.
I like them.
Oh, these are soccer teams, I'm assuming, right?
Football.
They look kind of premium.
Yeah, they're soccer teams. I don't know what... No.
Doesn't matter. I'm looking at the shoes. I don't care about the rest. Next up, we got Sneep Crew and Obscure Sneakers. Shout out to Obscure Sneakers. If you guys don't follow them on Instagram, follow them on Instagram. Super cool dude.
Fire.
Mahi Mahi. Very, very dope colorway.
Fire. The colorway is popping.
I've been excited to see these pop up. So,
yes, corduroy.
Did they come in grade school?
Corduroy tongue.
I can ask him.
Those are really fucking fire.
I think it's just,
shit out of those.
I don't think they got grade school. It's just like full size runs. I think the small, I think they might come in your size, certain models.
Those are fire.
I was on the website a few, it's hard to translate
it's
everything.
Fucking annoying as shit.
But it's really expensive for us to buy it and for it to get shipped out here, I think.
This is true. Next up, we got Slam Jam and Vans. Slam Jam, Vans. Slam Jam, Vans.
Oh, right.
Checkerboard. If you're into checkers, I'm with it.
I mean, that's just these so far.
And I think the Maya Moore 10, they dropped this weekend too, but I could be wrong.
Afterthoughts.
I forgot about those. I saw
those 10s are fire.
Yeah, those 10s are fire.
And I don't even like 10s.
Wow. I forgot about those.
Could I get a bone snap?
Match my fly.
Bone snap?
Afterthoughts.
Maybe wants to take.
I had to take over his shit. Like, he tried to take over mine.
She took the intro from me. So now she has this intro too. So
technically, you took it from him.
So she'll have the beginning intro
God.
And afterthoughts.
Technically,
intro.
He wasn't showing up.
I mean, one time?
It was more than one time.
Twice?
It was three times in a row that you did not want me on
He's
the show.
He's got years on the
my
show.
Way.
He's got years on the show.
I forced my way on United Souls.
He's
I forced
allowed
my
a vacation.
Way on the show.
Guy's allowed a vacation once in a while if he wants to not come for a show.
Guys, can we just be nice this week? It's my birthday.
I'm trying to have my intro.
Guy wants
intro
his intro. He wants his afterthoughts. What
he
do you
wants
want?
To read
what
everything.
Next? What do you want to take next? What do you want to take? What's up?
Nothing.
You want this side of the seat with me?
No. I'll let you get that chair. I'm nice.
All right, next up we got, what is this? Have retail shops lost the art of retail? Customer engagement. There's an Instagram post to go with this. I forget the gentleman's name, but shout out to Just Dave. He sent it over to me. I hear this a lot, as a matter of fact, about walking into a retail shop like a boutique and people just disregarding you. I don't know if you
message.
Guys can hit the comment section if you want to share
she's
your
she's
experiences.
She's taking a message now from me, see?
Did you say message?
She wants all the popping
wow.
shit.
Wow.
Yo,
all the popping
shit. I just
want
to be popping like you don't.
I know,
popping.
I know. It's all good.
Cool. Can we talk about this topic, though?
Yeah, we are.
Who's popping?
I don't shop at retail stores anymore.
Hmm.
Why? I work at night.
It's famous, so I guess everything sent.
No, I shop online. I take the risk of shopping online.
That sucks.
If I don't win the raffles in stores,
it is a risk.
Yeah, it is a risk. It's a big risk going online. I don't camp out anymore. Like, I'll do raffles.
So I didn't get that because I don't shop online.
Oh, they didn't come in your size.
I mean, I got them.
It wasn't your size.
Message!
Message! That's when you drop it, KB. It was something funny. But yeah, like, a lot of people shop online now. There's no more retail experience. Everybody's doing online raffles. No more camping out. But like all the hype releases and shit, like that's why it's like, this is what we're talking about. We're not talking about general shit.
We are talking about general shit. Like if
no,
you go to shop in a retail store,
you
a boutique,
go shop in a regular
a boutique,
shit.
A boutique on a
boutique
on
boutique.
A Monday.
A boutique.
Let's switch it up a little bit. On a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, whatever it is, you roll up in there, they ignore you. like, hands down, if they don't know you, there's this congregation thing where they're talking amongst each other. They give you, like, the, hey, what's up, man? And if it doesn't look like you're trying to spend mad money, they're like, all right, cool, let's go back to our conversation. I've seen it happen millions of times.
Mm.
Do you think that, is because they don't care or because hype has made them feel as though, and this is a personal opinion of mine, because of all the hype items on the weekend that drop and people coming in to buy them, no matter what size it is.
They feel special. They feel like they're, like... It's like a cop being a cop. Like,
do a lot of these retail stores work off of commission?
A lot of stores do commission.
So maybe that might have something to do with it, too.
When you go into Supreme, that they don't even say hello to you or acknowledge you like that.
No, they don't either. They're like, busy at the register.
No, like, not even that, no.
That
no.
used to be their thing, though. That used to be Supreme's thing. But if you are in a retail location and people are coming to shop, don't you think they should engage at minimum? Yeah. Like,
hey, how you doing? Welcome to the store.
Are you standing by something? Are you standing and staring at it for 10 minutes? And am I ignoring you while you're staring at it? Like, that's fucked up.
It is fucked up.
You should be engaging that customer on a loose basis. On a loose basis. Like, not tailing them. Like, hey, what are you
doing? Buy something. Hurry up and buy.
Look, have a good time. Yeah, I'm squeezing ass cheeks while I'm chasing you around the store. All I'm saying is they should be able to gauge.
Go like this.
Oh, hey, you.
Okay, back to talk.
They're reaching for the wallet. They should loosely follow you.
Yep.
Like, with their eyes, while they're doing their shit. Like, oh, they stopped over there for a minute. Let me go check and make sure they're all right. You good? All right, bet. And walk away. You know, it's simple. It's not that difficult. It's not rocket science. But, like, there's a lost technique here.
There's people skills, a lost technique.
Yes. Right.
That's what it is.
Yes.
So, it's the era of technology. It's all social shit.
Yes.
When you go out, a lot of people, they don't have those social characteristics that they need to interact on a daily basis with people.
Yeah, they'd rather, like, talk to people.
At my job, I work at a bar. If you don't know, you know. And a lot of, you know, people come in, you know, they're a little antisocial. They keep to themselves, a little timid. But, you know, after, you know, a few women, like, they come out a little bit. You know,
but, yeah. Come out a little bit.
So it takes, like, a certain person, I guess, have that kind of job.
Get new sales associates.
That's it.
I think that's what it comes down
to.
Next topic.
What Soulfly. Do you want from brands?
No. You're just giving stuff.
Soulfly release. Okay.
Soulfly release.
There's a little PowerPoint next to the shit.
This,
what the
fuck? That's not a PowerPoint. That's a fill in the blank for this answer.
You,
this
you is check question. It off? Check it off.
Damn, I don't know what I'm doing here.
Right. You can check it.
Soulfly release surprise. I think not.
So we've all seen
that
the video.
Shit got.
We all saw the video.
It was a wave. It was like, oh,
you knew this was going to happen. I knew it was going to happen. I'm not surprised.
100%.
It was like,
are you surprised?
No.
Okay.
It was like this.
Oh, my statement's right.
It was waving.
My statement's right.
Okay.
Surprised? I think not.
I think not.
So I got the inside track on a little bit of what went down
dead.
There.
Bye.
Touchdown. This is over.
Just smash that shit on the floor. I got a little bit of inside track on what went down. From the video, it looks like there's maybe 200 people there.
Yo, crazy. And
realistically, there's 700 people there.
Damn.
And there's only like 200 pairs.
And there's only like two guards. So.
No, they had to have more security.
They had a couple different locations, and at none of those locations were Nike security, were Soulfly employees, or barricades until that situation started to arise.
What
now,
the fuck?
There's supposed to be 1,500 pairs of the GR release.
Okay.
That's not even like a physical thing. So. There was another number, which was 283 pairs were going to be released
in Miami.
The
Pat Leather one, right?
No, just 283 pairs, and then a wider release in January. Most people don't.
But we're talking about the Pat Leather
pair. We're talking about the GR pair.
Okay, the regular shit.
Yeah, it's the regular shit, the regular degular shit. Now, Soulfly, I don't care if you're watching or somebody from there is watching, is known for fucking up releases. Known for it. Since the Gelite 3 that they did from Soulfly, where they had the release at the location.
Those were nice. And that was a fucking mayhem.
They had to move the location to a part outside of Miami. Pairs went missing. People didn't get that supposedly had numbers. They had the boat shit last year, but I think it was in a different setup. And security was there for the yacht shit. You guys, I don't know if you guys remember. It was like on a yacht. It was a whole bunch of pairs. And like you had to walk there to get. So the line was like pretty organized. This year, again, some fucketry. Now...
The
17s, I know.
They dropped a pair of 17s, too.
Yes, I have them.
No, those are the 16s. 17s are the yellow pair.
What?
The 17s, the yellow
pair. Oh, yeah. Trent.
That was a fuck-up shit, too.
Yeah, but, like, either way, I'm pretty sure they backdoor pairs. I mean, and they created more hype to backdoor their own pairs.
Then they're going
to
be worth more money.
By fucking up their own release.
These are all allegations, by the way.
Yeah, this is allegedly. Allegedly.
This is all conspiracy theories. This is just us thinking.
Allegedly.
Next.
I'm sorry. I just.
Damn.
Allegedly.
Ranch.
Allegedly.
Ranch over.
But this shit happens to a lot of stores anyway.
We don't have a topic.
I'm still stuck on this.
My shit's dead, so you gotta
next one. I brought up the Alley May joints and the Maya Moore joints.
The tens are fire.
The tens and the ones. I do like what's going on here. I hate the division of men's and women's.
Right. It should just be unisex sizing.
Right? I just feel like they should just cut this shit out and just put shoes out.
No more boys, no more girls.
Fuck it. Like,
no more men's sizes.
Everybody's wearing this shit.
Size 4 through 18.
Yeah.
That's it.
Cut it out.
Just call it a wrap.
Cut this division shit out.
Like. But that'll bring people complaining that wear size 4 through 7. Because they're like, oh, it's grade school. It shouldn't cost as much as a men's sport.
No, I don't care. I've been paying the same amount for Asics.
If you buy runners, you know the deal.
Exactly.
So you wouldn't mind paying $200 retail for a pair?
No, I paid $200 retail for a pair of Asics that Mike paid $200 retail for.
So, like, the only problem here is, like, kids
and collabos
that are growing.
But those are, like, different companies. I'm talking about, like, Nike, like bigger companies, like Asics. You know, we're paying that.
But I'm saying if I pay that for Asics, I'll pay that for Nike.
No, I'm saying we're paying that for the quality. Like we're paying that retail for the quality we're getting back.
I get that, but like at the same time, you guys have to understand, Nike does a kid's price point for the simple fact that your kid grows rapidly. So you want to spend $200 on a pair of ones
that they're going to go
that they're going to grow out of in 3 months. I think that's the bigger issue with the price point on that. Like, you're going to buy your kid a pair of shoes, and next week they might be out of them.
And it's less technology. Like, they don't have the air units most of the time, or they don't.
Yeah.
The quality is a little different from grade school, which is kind of fucked up.
They would have to make, like, an adult division where it's a size one of the shit, and it's all one price point. Which is, and that becomes kind of a tricky thing. Like, how do you pick and choose what shoe you're going to give that run to with a good quality, and what are you going to make, like, just standard shit? You know what I'm saying? Like,
I think the unisex size will be good. I think a lot of people will agree. Like, let us know in the comments below.
I feel like they could round out the price point to equalize if they really wanted to.
Unisex sizing, just 4 through 18 or whatever the biggest size they make.
I mean,
I'm with it.
I get the quality differential, but like you're an adult that wears a smaller size.
Yeah, so okay.
What size you
wear? So you don't give a shit because all your shit's going to be the same. Four and a half? So like, it's always going to be the same for her, but like, a 12-year-old that wears a fucking 9 is going to go to whatever else. You know what I'm saying? So like, it becomes a little tricky at that point.
Or maybe they just wear different suits.
They still be jacking up the price, though. $170 for Concords. That was crazy.
Wild. Yeah, next up, we got, what do you want to see from brands in 2019? What do you want to see?
I want to see more quality control.
Better quality as well.
I'm going to have to pull up last year's video just before the end. And I feel like we said quality control.
Yeah, but still, you see some people's Concords that they be getting in the mail.
We're still demanding quality control.
One don't say 45.
Shut the fuck up.
There's glue stains on the back.
Yeah, a few pairs have like that on the was, like this shit came like black.
And like over here.
Yeah, and some spots have like mold and shit. Like this is wild.
Listen, if I got a pair that said 45 on one and nothing on the other, I would be happy.
Yeah. I don't mind the 45 or 23. I don't give a fuck about what number
it's like. No, it said nothing.
No, I'm saying, but I don't care if it said 23 or 45 or nothing. Like,
it's Concord. Did you get a pair?
Yeah, I got a pair.
I did.
Did I?
I'm not a big fan of Concord, but I just got it. I got it just because.
Like, in my life of collecting shoes, how much I love Jordans and say I'd, like, be buried in them, that now I don't even. Like, I don't see the purpose of me getting three of the same shoe when I still have the other pair.
You grew out of them.
I mean, I still love J's.
And they don't last. Like, after a certain amount of years,
yellow,
you try to wear them again. Like,
and
that's just
fucked. Comfortable is, like, now I be wearing runners, and runners are so much comfortable. So when I wear that, it's like, meh.
I agree.
I'd rather be comfortable.
You pamper your feet with, like, the higher-end running shoes, then we go back to J's, and it's like,
I mean,
damn.
It's about fashion.
This shit fucking hurts.
It does. I'm going to move on to the next topic
Let's
here.
Do it.
We're moving into, what are they called? Viewer comments.
Oh, wait.
That's what we're doing.
Viewer comments.
Do you want to read the first one,
KB?
Hey. Hashtag, it's your boy Molly Mall.
What are you looking at me for?
Because I wanted you to say what you were saying.
Addicted to Molly?
No.
Jamali? Where do you want to go with?
Hashtag Petty. We don't speak in Spanish here.
13 hours ago.
Oh, word.
I mean, if we're going to read it.
What are your collective thoughts on Art Basel release and for Basel. Mike? How would you handle the release? Camp out.
Is there anything else you want
to do? Seems like they needed your help. Anyway, happy early birthday, KB.
There you go. Hashtag Molly out. And that is a male, by the way. He's a male.
It's not a she.
The Art Basel release, like we just spoke about, was poorly handled. Piss poor planning, as I like to call it.
Yes.
You know there's going to be people. All you got to do is go on StockX, see what the price is at. If
yes.
the price is high, obviously people will be out there whether they want the shoe or not. They're going to flip it because it becomes resell over whatever the fuck it is that you're putting out.
So, and people that are not even part of the community are going to be out there just trying to make money as well.
Exactly.
So you're going to deal with a bunch of different types of people.
It's an open market at that point. And as per that, you should definitely be prepared. So, I mean, realistically, you guys know the right moves to make. You could have security there for a set amount of time, handing out numbers, giving out raffles, giving out bracelets.
Well, that shit won't matter like 2 minutes before the store's open. Like, everything goes to shit.
I mean, it's honestly, if you follow and you stay with the line the entire time, nothing goes wrong. But the second you start deliberating who's got to get special pairs and who you got to pull pairs for and what you have to do inside and forget about the overcrowding outside is when you screw yourself. Every single time. Never fails. Not feeling it? Next up, we got Escobar Jr. season one day ago.
Shout out.
Your
thoughts on SneakerCon NYC not happening in 2018?
It didn't happen
because
this year?
Because they couldn't get the venue.
SneakerCon.
That's why.
What, SneakerCon? That was
I didn't even know if they didn't happen this year. I had no idea.
It's supposed to be like right
now,
this weekend.
SneakerCon, that was hashtag petty. KB, I need that merch. And
Camp
Out, I need that hoodie. LOL.
Tone's here. Hello. Tone of my voice. We're here. Every Thursday on a Thursday.
Without merch.
Without merch.
So, SneakerCon, I could give two shits about. I don't care about SneakerCon.
SneakerCon New York is pretty whack.
It's played out. I'm not a fan.
It's become a oversaturated selling place. Once they put the trading pit, I was over SneakerCon. I didn't like the kid standing in the aisle with shoes either, but like they should have just cracked down on that instead of making it conform to them. So a giant trading pit with kids sweating.
It's not just kids, it's adults as well.
It's
families go to. It's not just a bunch of little kids.
It's a lot of
kids. It's
families. Give me a percentage. Give me a percentage. How many?
I wouldn't know. I haven't been to one in like years.
I've
recently. You've been to one recently in a different state.
Yeah, I didn't
too, as well.
It was better in a different state. It's better in a different state.
Is
different
it?
States
it's
definitely different.
Here is just because there's so many people trying to sell the items that they
too
have.
Many sellers, not a lot of buyers. All the buyers are buying through the
yeah,
apps.
But also there they don't have
through the
they don't have the shoes that we have here.
Yeah. The acquiring's harder out of state.
They don't have like I was the only person in the whole place with Serena's, like in the whole place.
Huh.
Where?
At SneakerCon Atlanta.
Atlanta?
Atlanta.
Atlanta. Atlanta, Georgia.
Damn.
Nerd.
Yeah, reach
out.
Time.
What are we doing here?
Streetwear.
Oh, volume is on. Streetwear dad underscore one day ago. Hashtag petty. Another great episode, fam. Hashtag fist. I'm really excited for the air of fear of God. You guys alright?
Just wait for you to finish, bud.
What are your thoughts?
Oh, we did this already.
Yeah, we already spoke about it.
We spoke about it during the episode.
Shout out Streetwear Dad. Shout out to you.
Really, the main point of that was to shout you out. Oh, you want to read the next one? He's going to hand it back over. Down the line we go.
Hot potato, hot.
Arios 1976. Hashtag petty. Question. What EU release would you guys want
to
have?
You're talking to me in camera.
Because you're being annoying.
Bro.
What EU release would you guys want to have see released in the U.S.? All the ASICS collabos that will be dropping there are not here.
I really wanted that off-white.
And those off-white, those all white, too.
Mike, you were saying something?
What are you doing? Gotcha.
Yeah.
Mike, you were saying something?
Let me finish my thought.
Well, you said one.
I said one.
You're going to take everything? You're going to take everything and then... I don't know.
Meta?
Message!
Really? Like, what the fuck? Yeah, there's quite a few things that drop it, like especially their inline in UK is definitely better than the inline here. I don't know.
It's still not my shoes.
I give up.
Mike, laughing.
Sure, you like the Adores. next up, we
Mike
got
finished. Come on,
Michael right. Jenkins 3 days ago.
Shout out, Michael
hashtag
Jenkins.
Hashtag petty. Dope show as always. Question. Favorite collab of 2018? Hmm. You'll just have to wait.
Stay tuned. Stay
You'll
tuned.
You'll just
my
have to wait,
stay
my friend.
Tuned.
No inside track for you.
No
soup for you.
We're gonna fight it out on live. It's gonna be live, guys, on 12:30.
Once I figure out how to do live, it'll definitely
12:30.
Next up, we got Amber.
That's the time we're shooting it.
5 days ago, edited.
No.
Wait, 30 hours.
The day before.
That's 30 days.
Anyway, hashtag petty. Question: what is the best shoe this year?
It's a Sunday.
Year you haven't got but could get if you wanted to. Best shoe of this year that you haven't got but you could get if you wanted to.
I mean, I probably can't afford it.
Which is?
Kind of want
unions. Oh, so what? The unions. Ooh.
I'm gonna get those before Christmas.
Unions were nice. I won't pay resale on them. Retail or bust?
I want both pairs, but I'll go with the blue ones for now.
No more limited pair?
Mm-hmm. Huh. What about you?
Stump me, bud. And I put this question in here. I shouldn't think about it.
Yeah, I don't even know what questions you get to pick, so I come here not knowing what the fuck's gonna happen.
Once, that's why.
No, it's not why.
Ooh.
I mean, you do, though.
Ooh.
Things I don't say out loud, by the way.
I mean,
what things did I miss out?
I'm trying to think what I so missed out on what I wanted.
I'm trying to think, too. This is a good montage right here.
KB Hirachi's?
Well, I got the pair that I wanted from that collection.
Shut up. I know. Ronnie's other New Balance, because there's a few pairs in there.
I guess it was a shoe that I could have if I wanted to. Yeah. So yeah, I guess the 997 Sport Fusion in the black and pink colorway. And I'll probably get it before the year's over. So
see?
They have them.
Exactly why I'll probably get it.
They were sitting in Kif.
Yeah, I might get one.
It's Kif Soho. They had a size 11.
Yeah, I'm probably going to get it.
It might be too big. I don't know if they have it. No, you should have...
Anyway,
but yeah, but I was like, I don't want to buy another one because I bought two. So I'm like, shit, do I want to buy more? All right, next.
You should have said yeah.
So we take Black Thunder. There you go, get in there.
KB, you want to read?
Black Thunder, 5 days ago. Penny, what shoes are you trying to get before the year ends? Also, how are you guys going to do top shoes of the year? Of the year, new silhouette only. We're not saying that. We're just saying that the retro shoe can't be number one. Like, I can't put Concord as number one.
I mean, I don't mind putting it in because I really don't care.
It could be in.
If it dropped in 2018, I will count.
Can retros make the list? Just wondering. Oh, what do you guys ten shoes of the year personally? We're probably gonna hash it out. We all have to bring one shoe of the six shoes that we have in the top.
I'm gonna do something a little different this year.
What are we doing?
At the end of the episode, what I'm going to do is, like, during the credits, I'm going to put, like, KB's name and pictures of her top 10 is what I'm going to do.
Oh, cool.
You know what I'm saying? I'll put his name and his top 10.
And then we'll have our final top 18 of 18.
There's another question there.
Oh.
What shoe would you guys try to get before the end of the year? I'm trying to get Mentas and Unions.
Why are you so aggressive?
Really?
You're so mean. Why are you so mean to the camera?
Honestly, I want the off-white Air Force One and the lime green color.
Oh, those two. Oh, shit. Those dropped though. Those aren't reselling.
I'm trying to get before the end of the year.
Me too. You're right. Sorry. Oh my god.
I mean, what the fuck? What? Yeah, you're just spewing out fucking shoes. What was it, 8 shoes you gotta get before the year's over?
No, 2. 3.
7.
3.
14.
It's my birthday.
18. Next up we got, Sneaker Battle. Sneaker Battle. Tone.
Yo.
Victor. Oh wow, we tied for a second.
Did what was the final numbers?
37, 31, 31.
What?
Wow, this is the first tie in 50 weeks.
What was I wearing?
What?
What was that word?
It's 56 weeks.
You were wearing a New Balance, I can tell you that much. Pray to the J. Crew.
No, it was the first. We haven't been doing this 50 weeks.
No, I wasn't wearing New Balance.
You wore New Balance.
You wore the blue J. Crew New Balance.
Yeah, you did.
With the burgundy end.
All right, Tone, you go first. Go.
You got to go for it. This is your king. This is your king. Forget it.
Bread 11s. 2012 or 2013. One of those. I don't remember.
Yeah, whatever.
It's probably 2012. Use it for the rain, the snow. That's it.
Use it for the rain or the snow.
Now let's go back to the closet.
KB, you can go since we tied.
I'm going to lose, but only because the people are going to say, oh, it's a hype shoe. But honestly, it is the dopest shoe on the panel. So even if I lose, whatever. You know what I got? Off-white. UNC ones.
Yeah, hold it still so it focuses. See that little...
I'm focused, man.
Off-white UNC ones. They look better dog, to be honest.
I feel the same way
Peters.
About the Chicago's.
Yeah.
Fuck you, bro. I can't even get those.
Can't even have an opinion. Your boy went a little classic today. Air Max TN Plus for those of you who would rather call it Plus. Just a little black, little red.
It's a good battle, Mike, between you and me.
It's my joint right here.
Good battle.
Great.
Next up, hit the comment section. We had 32 comments last week.
39. I checked today.
So we had a couple more since last night at 11 p.m. Anyway, shout outs to everybody that commented last week. Going to take a couple of the notes into the 2018 of 18. Shout out to everybody who donated last week. And those people are from the Super Chat Unboxed app and Tones Giblets twice. So Tones Giblets. You get where I'm going with this. Last week's hashtag was...
Shout out to you, Tone. Petty. Shout out to you.
Bye. Anyway... back into this. Last week's hashtag was hashtag petty. You're off the camera, by the way.
Am I?
Yeah. And you're back. This week's hashtag is hashtag V-Day Girl, if I'm not mistaken.
Whose week is it for hashtag?
It's for you.
Yeah, I'm not gonna use that one.
No, no, it's actually yours.
Mike used Petty last week for himself.
I use Petty,
I told him not to use it, and he said, no, Gabby's next week.
Yeah, it's your birthday this week. What the fuck?
No shit, so that's why it's not
hashtag B-Day Girl. Girl.
KB, how old are you gonna be?
89.
So, if you... Oh, God, fuck.
Did your mother ever teach you whenever it's a lady her age is rude?
We don't have equal rights now,
well,
so...
you are not a lady.
Wow. I'm not... Yo, that's so fucked up.
No, you're a sneaker connoisseur.
I'm not a lady.
You're one of the fellas.
You gotta cover it like that.
You're one of the dudes.
You are a sneaker
connoisseur. I'm one of the dudes, but I don't have dude parts.
No, I don't
anatomy.
Know.
I don't have dude anatomy, so I have women anatomy.
I don't know.
All right, Jaguar, chill out. What's
that's none of my business.
Chuck Whale. Yo, anybody watch Love and Hip Hop? Yo, she's mad funny. She'll be mad because I got a nice penis to you.
Oh, do you? Wow, good for you. If you use hashtag Petty last week, you got a shout out. Here it goes. B, Michael Lewinsky, Toilet Bowl Poop, Dr. Souls 11, chillin'. Molly Mall, Addicted to Molly, Streetwear Dad _, Randy Watson 074, Michael Jenkins, K22 Shit, E. Doucette, chillin'. Chris Janik, Alex Dimitrioff, Amber
Chris Janik.
John Passarella, J Paz, chillin'. Official DKNO, ESL, Black Thunder, Al V2, and AOROS 1976.
Hey yo. That's it, that's everybody.
I don't know where D-Lo's at, but.
D-Lo, what up?
D-Lo.
We chillin'. Here. Every Thursday on Thursday, 8 p.m.
I think that's it for this week's episode. Stay tuned. Good, that's it.
Stay tuned.
Yeah. Throw a thumbs up if you're watching still. Man, whatever.
If you want to come out Sunday, leave a comment.
What are we doing Sunday? What is Sunday?
Matt's putting it on the fucking video.
If you're still watching, reached out to a guy to do some merch. You can do a 12 run because I want to do some samples for some new hoodies. If you guys are interested, I will be doing a pre-order for them. So,
holla.
All right.
We out!
You out.
When the MCs came!